I'm becoming less and less private. I'd much rather be an idiot. The book, in this picture, the assumption was made that the book was the source and cause of all idiotism, all individuality, and that the new media will turn us all into collective automata robots. This is a rather simple-minded idea. I mean, Truffaut and Bradbury together had cooked up something that's not very convincing. It's certainly true that the book has had an enormous amount to do with creating individuality. And the more people become individuals, the more they become competitive. And the more they compete, the more they become alike. It's true that competition has, and repeatability has tended to create a great sameness. And you can see that cool media don't always have that effect. There may be more individuality coming out of cool media.
You've been quoted as saying that you don't necessarily agree with everything that you say.
I have no point of view. As for example, now, see, I couldn't possibly have a point of view. I'm just moving around and picking up information from many directions. No, a point of view means a static fixed position, and you can't have a static fixed position in the electric gate. It's impossible to have a point of view in the electric gate and have any meaning at all. You've got to be everywhere at once, whether you like it or not. You have to be participating in everything going on at the same time, and that is not a point of view.
Would it really matter if someone burned all the books in the world?
Well, I should think so. It would make quite a difference. But the possibility of recreating libraries has now become fantastically real. For example, all the books in the world can be put on a single desktop, 20 million. 20 million books can now be put open every page on a single desktop by microfilm. The sort of things that are happening make that Truffaut picture look rather obsolete. They still think of books as made as bound paper objects, but in the new microfilm age, microcartridge and so on, the book is taking on a totally new meaning. In the age of Xerox, the book takes on a totally new meaning. It becomes an information service. It ceases to be a package. The book is no longer a package. It's information service.
Bigger populations of school children seem automatically to call for larger school spaces, but the sort of dialogue among all the elements of our world that is going on actually and without benefit of bureaucratic blessing or an official blessing, the kind of exchanges and interchanges of imagery and awareness of peoples of the world, this is the pattern I think that education will tend to resort to more and more. Instead of locating people, for example, in a particular space to teach them, say, German or Chinese, they will be moved to Germany or China to learn those things, by circuitry or physically. Physically. Or they could be moved by circuitry. But as far as that goes, in our own world, we are hurrying back and forth across town at morning and night to situations which we could quite easily encompass by closed circuit. Why do the wheels keep hurrying us downtown? Some people are puzzled by this and have come up with the answer. It's the filing cabinet downtown in the offices that makes it still necessary to rush back and forth from suburb to office. That it is this obsession with the contents of the file, documents, contracts, data. All of these materials actually could be just as available on closed circuit at home. The stockbroker long ago discovered this, that the telephone enables him to conduct his business anywhere. He doesn't have to hurry down to the stock exchange.
So the tycoon, like Paul Getty, who does most of his business by telephone.
But we still have this obsessional, compulsive drive to fit into patterns, to fit into classifications, which says our job is down here. That's why we're terrified when automation threatens to integrate us, so that all the old fragmentary jobs go back into a circuit of wholeness.
But isn't that inevitable?
And circuitry has already brought this about at many levels of our life. And the flying of it to the industrialized areas of fragmented and specialist tasks and work is inevitable, yes, because it's already happening. You see, our marketing, for example, is way ahead of our production processes. As the speed gets faster, it's, I suppose, as if all the members of an orchestra began to play 1,000 times faster, but some only 100 times faster. You would get a crazy pattern, wouldn't you, in a big orchestra?